Today, we want to talk about perspective, right? We've been looking at this idea of where we set our thoughts, what we allow or require our minds to dwell upon. Well, very easy for us to all of a sudden have our minds distracted by some problem, some conundrum, some issue we have in life that begins to take on a life of its own. And so today I want you to think about your problems. Problems must be faced, or else they remain forever a barrier to the growth and development of our spirit. And so your problems can't just be swept under a rug. Your problems just can't be ignored. They've got to be looked at, but they've got to be looked at through a perspective of the good news. Jesus changes our problems. So right off the bat, in Ephesians chapter 3, verse 1, Paul says, Paul, a prisoner of the Lord Jesus. For this reason, Paul, a prisoner of the Lord Jesus. For what reason? For the reason of this new identity we have built on the foundation of Christ, built with the collection of people that are making us into a part of a whole church, a whole group of people representing God in the world. This people that have this new identity and purpose to fill everything with His presence. For this reason, because of this new identity, Paul, a prisoner of the Lord Jesus Christ. He doesn't say a prisoner of Rome. He says a prisoner of Christ. That I'm in prison, but I'm been captured by Jesus. I don't know what's imprisoning you. I don't know what's captured you. But if Jesus has not captured you, then some circumstance has. The thing that changes, one of the most powerful changes for anyone who's united with Christ, is how we view our problems. We have a God that's promised us that whatever happens to us, He will work out for the good of those who love Him. That's Romans 8:28. That's a promise. God promises that nothing can separate us from the love of God, neither height nor depth, angels nor demons, the present nor the future, nor any powers, nor any difficulties, nor any problems. Nothing can separate us from Him. That means my perspective changes right in the middle of my problem. You've heard me say, if you've been around me very long, that we've got to stop trying to get out of our problems and start asking God what He wants us to get out of our problems. It's a change of perspective. What challenge, what problem are you facing today? Because this is my promise to you. Whatever your problem is, it's the tool He's using to make you more like Him. Whatever problem you're facing is the tool He's using to make you more like Him. Today, Lord, we ask You, change us. You don't have to change our problem, Lord, but You do need to change us in the midst of our problem. When everything we've tried does not change our circumstances, God, help us to recognize it's because You're wanting to change us. Lord, we love You, and we seek today to be more like You through what we require our minds to dwell upon, this good news that we are called and chosen by You to make a difference in the problems of life. In Jesus' name, amen. I'll see you tomorrow.